Point of View is an awesome HMI SCADA application that allows you to view your runtime app remotely three different ways. The Secure Viewer, which is a thin client that requires only an installation of the Secure Viewer software. A Web Thin Client, which uses a browser to access the Point of View app. And a Mobile Access Viewer, so you can monitor your system on the go on most current tablets, phones, and desktops. Now, setting up remote access over a network can be frustrating and time-consuming. So to help you get up and running as quickly as possible with Point of View, we've created this video guide to help walk you through the process in small, easy-to-follow, logical steps. First, we'll access the Point of View Runtime app from Internet Explorer right on the same PC using Local Loopback. This verifies that the Point of View application is working and the files are set up correctly, without having to worry about hardware drivers and network settings and routers and gateways and all that other stuff. Next, we'll do the exact same thing, but this time we'll use the actual IP address of the runtime machine. We're still local, so no network hardware is involved, but we are using network addressing, and we're using this PC's network adapter driver and hardware. So now we know we can access the Point of View app via networked IP addressing. Finally, we'll access the runtime application from a remote PC over the full network. Since we know the Point of View app and its IP addressing are working, if things don't work at this stage, then we know it's a network thing and can focus our debugging energy on just that. We'll do this full network testing first with the NT web server, then with the Microsoft IIS web server, which is what you want to use in your final app because it supports all of Point of View's features and it's much more robust and secure than the NT web server. The reason we use the NT web server first is because it doesn't require any setup, so it'll get your app up and running a lot faster. Please don't use the NT web server in your final system because it'll open up your system to all kinds of security threats. Taking a few minutes to walk through these step-by-step tutorials will save you hours or even days of heartburn and frustration. Of course, issues do pop up, so we'll do a little troubleshooting video at the end to show you how to handle issues you may run into. So take your time, follow along with the videos, and pretty soon you too will have a whole new Point of View from Automation Direct.com.